Hey everybody, I just wanted to post a quick video of the completed Leslie Model 16 project I've been working on the past few months. Okay, in a second here, you're going to see that it has a new foot switch, and the foot switch has an LED indicator on it that pulses at two speeds to indicate the fast and slow Leslie speeds. We've got a little LFO circuit in there driving the LED and a double pole foot switch with half controlling the LFO and the other half controlling the relay and the Leslie. And can see that it's flashing at a higher rate of speed, and I step on it and it'll change to a slow. It's a little more prominent in real life. On the video, it doesn't seem to pick it up quite as well. Okay, now as we go back to the rear of the unit, you'll notice that it has its own amp. Leslie 16s and Fender Vibratones didn't originally have amps in them. They hooked up to a host guitar amp via the little line inline crossover, which sent mid-range to the Leslie and the lows to the host amp speaker. I never really liked that sound, so I decided to do this one a little different. This is approximately 20 watts running cathode bias 6V6s. The transformers are salvaged from a Hammond M2 from the early 50s. It's an old organ. I got the volume, treble, and bass controls. You see it has two speaker outputs and another knob marked HF. That's an L pad controlling the volume on a little dome tweeter I've got mounted in front of the main speaker. The main speaker is a Jensen Neo 10. I wanted the sound to be a little more akin to the big old Leslie 122 or 147s, you know, the ones that have a bass rotor and a treble horn. These just have the foam bass rotor. So the goal is to get more of that shimmery tone come through, but I also want it to be controllable. That's why it has an L pad. Now I'll play a little through it, and I've got it close mic'd with a 57 and an MXL 960 tube condenser. Is picking up the left side a few feet back.
Thank you. Thank you.